Hello, in this video, I will show you the different ways for interacting with TNT. There are two main ways of interacting with TNT. The first one is by using the graphical user interface or the GUI. The GUI version of TNT is only available for Windows. However, if we have Linux or Mac, we can use compatibility layers to run the GUI version. For example, Wine. This is my case because I have Ubuntu, so I will use Wine for this tutorial. The use of the GUI used to be very intuitive and straightforward, as we can perform different kind of analysis only with 3 or 4 mouse clicks. There are 8 main menus, as you can see here, but perhaps the most important are the menus Trees, Data, and Analyze. However, the other menus also have nice functionalities. It would be possible to make a different video for each one of these menus, but our purpose here is just to show the main options needed to load data files and script files, because in the next videos we will show how to use the scripts that we developed for phylogenomics. So, to open and load a data file or a script file, we just have to go to the menu File. Then we need to choose the option Open Input File. And then we need to choose the file that we want. This file could contain data, trees, and script. For this example, I will use an alignment and a tree from this paper of López Osorio and colleagues. First, I will load the alignment in TNT. Okay, that's all. The matrix has these dimensions. Now, let's open the tree. It's quite similar. Okay, and here is the tree. And finally, I will run a script. This is the script that I will use for this example. It's quite simple and is available in GitHub. You can pause the video to see the comments and what the script do. Please be sure about the name of your dataset. In my case, I will use the same dataset of López Osorio and colleagues. So let's run it in TNT. Here is the script, issue that run, and here the script is performing the analysis. And that's all about the use of the GUI. Here is one of the results from the script. You can see here the tree with the jackknife support values. Now I want to show you the second way to interact with TNT. This is by using the console. The console version of TNT is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. Very important thing, be sure that you are working into the folder or directory where you have your data files. In my case is the folder multi-m. And this is the complete path of this folder. I just need to type TNT to open the program. In the console version, the commands are typed directly at the prompt here. The use of the console is not as intuitive as the use of the GUI, because you need to know some of the main commands used by TNT. A good advice to know these commands is to use, for example, the help. The commands of interest for this video are the commands procedure and the command run. So, as an example, I will ask for the help of the command procedure. Okay, this is the entire information about this command, and now let's open the data file. We just need to type procedure and the name of the data file. And that's all. It's the same for the tree, but obviously with a different file. Okay, sorry. Here is the tree. And let's run the script. For this, we need to use the command run. Or even we can use also the command procedure. But first, we will need to use run. As I mentioned, we also can use a procedure to run the script, but when we use procedure, we can use scripts without arguments. For scripts with arguments, we need to use the command run. For that reason, we recommend the use of the command run for scripts. This is the end of this tutorial, and see you in the next videos.